The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus raised his eyes to heaven and said, I pray not only for them, but also for those who believe in me through their testimony, so that they may all be one, as you, Father, are in me, and I in you, that they also may be in us, that the world may believe that you sent me. And I have given them the glory you gave me, so that they may be one as we are one, I in them and you in me, that they may be brought to perfection as one, that the world may know that you sent me and that you loved them even as you have loved me. Father, they are your gift to me. I wish that where I am, they also may be with me, and that they may see my glory that you gave me, because you loved me before the foundation of the world. Righteous Father, the world also does not know you, but I know you, and they know that you sent me. I have made known to them your name, and I will make it known that the love with which you loved me may be in them, and I in them. My brothers and sisters, this is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Connection with the gospel of Jesus. And this year, I have invited a longtime member of this community of St. Matthew, Annette Ottone. I met Annette and her husband, Remo, back in 87. It was a long time ago, to do their wedding, and they became members of our community, and in fact, Annette sang in the choir, and that was before Mirella, or Mimi, was around. So they've been longtime members, but since 2001, they have relocated to San Diego, so we don't see them every Sunday, but whenever I have an excuse to bring them up here, like Mother's Day, I'm always delighted to see them again. So I want you to welcome our guest panelist this morning, Annette Ottone, as she now speaks to us about the meaning and her experience about being a mother. So thank you, Annette.
Is a great place to give thanks and seek forgiveness. So I'm going to do both. My name is Annette, and I thank you for sharing the next moments of your life with me. It is such an honor to speak in this house. Please forgive me if I read some of this to you, but I want to make sure that I say everything that I came here to. Today, we celebrate all women who have had the occasion to protect, love, and wish good things for our children. So whether you're bio mother, other mother, adopted mother, guardian, grandmother, godmother, auntie, nanny, teacher, mentor, or neighbor, this day celebrates you. Happy Mother's Day. I'm going to share two things with you. One, how we found St. Matthew Church, and two, my coming out story. This is an account of two journeys taken 24 years apart. Two journeys fraught with conflict and resolution thereof. Two journeys in which the power of love, is love, prevailed. I learned of St. Matthew Church from a bridal fair in 1987 when my fiancé, Remo, and I were planning our wedding. The ad read something like, "Want a Catholic wedding but can't get married in the Catholic Church?" Oh, it seemed the perfect solution for us. So we scheduled an appointment to meet with a Father Peter Hickman in the old world village of Huntington Beach. It was an odd setting, to be sure, but we met with him anyway, and we liked what we heard in that Get to Know You interview. We also were told that we would be required to attend a couple of services just to make sure we knew what we were getting into. So we did, and the services were welcoming, familiar, and relevant. In those humble beginnings, Father Peter even played guitar and sang. We were really small. Kind of like that I Love Lucy episode where the guy is wearing all the hats. He's the conductor, the hotel person, the everything. Anyway, he was so nice that this little church in the old world village immediately felt like home. Not only did Remo and I want this priest to perform our wedding ceremony, but we wanted to become members of St. Matthew Old Catholic Church. Professionally, he became our priest, and personally, he became our good friend. In those first visits, we learned a few things. Father Peter had a son named Nathan and a wife named Angela. Statements that always prompted my very Roman Catholic mother into asking, "What kind of Catholic church is this in?" Initially, I answered her questions as best I could, but eventually got tired of the same question over and over. So I handed her the blue pamphlet. Catherine, I know you know what that blue pamphlet is. It explained all things St. Matthew. And guess what? After a considerable amount of time, prayer and reflection, my very Roman Catholic mother passed her wedding band, which was also my grandmother's, on to me. She had four daughters to choose from, but she chose our ceremony with Father Peter to be the one that would forever link my family's past to what would be my family's future. She passed that ring on to me because not only did she have faith in my marriage to Rima, she also had faith in the ability of this humble, welcoming church, St. Matthew, married priest, and all. Some of my favorite things about our wedding day are the readings from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians on love. Father Peter talking about the children we might have one day, and the image of Father Peter dancing to Billy Idol's White Wedding. Some of my favorite things about St. Matthew Church are their inclusivity, or their consistent welcome of everyone without exception. Even when the without exception has placed this faith community at a crossroads and resulted in heartbreak and lost membership, St. Matthew has always remained true to its words. All are welcome. And I'm certain, though, Peter, it's easier to sleep at night knowing you've done the right and loving thing versus whatever it took to retain your financial base. They're big on forgiveness here at St. Matthew. I should know, my kids have heard me fight with Father Peter and Bishop Peter over the years, and I've been a direct recipient of forgiveness from him and Mirella both. Because no matter how great our differences or out of step our paths, the bottom line is this, my other favorite thing about St. Matthew Church, they truly strive to live by Christ's words, to love one another. Because that's what we do when we're a family. And now for my family. Yes, I did say my coming out story. How, you ask, can a straight woman come out? I'm going to tell you. One of the many hats I wear is as a regional director for Peep Like San Diego. Can you still hear me?
Yeah.
I'm on my feet. PSIC is a national network that provides support, education, and advocacy to everyone that are beautiful, lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, or queer, or LGBTQ for short, or as short as we could get it, to everyone that our LGBTQ rainbow touches or means to touch, with the simple goal of equality for all. A type of consistent welcome of everyone without exception. I think most parents can remember the joy we felt holding our newborns. Mothers, do you remember how grateful we were for their health and how firm our resolve was to protect them, to love them, and wish good things for them? These are the implicit callings of motherhood. I began my journey with PFLAG 4.5 years ago when one of my babies felt supported and empowered enough to come out to Remo and me. I had so many questions for her, and initially she answered them as best she could, but eventually she tired of them and told me, "Mom, go to a PFLAG meeting." She handed me a pamphlet. "PFLAG will help you. They'll answer your questions." "I've got homework to do, Mom." Little did I know, I had some homework to do too. And I'd like to share with you a few things I've learned about coming out. Coming out is a process or journey, and everyone's process or journey is different. Number two, it is the entire family that comes out, not just the LGBTQ individual. We come out every day. You lose some friends at the crossroads. You keep the friends that are willing to take this journey with you, and you make some amazing new friends, like my friend Mark and family over there. It took our team 2 years to come out to Rima and me, because she was afraid of the possible repercussions. She came out her senior year of high school after an out-of-state visit to a college that was recruiting her to play basketball. It was very late and we were so very tired. Her words, "Mom, Dad, I'm gay. My stunned words as I held my daughter, "That's okay, sweetie. Thank you for telling us. I love you. I love you." I will say, I was not expecting those four words to come out of her mouth. I thought she was going to say, "Mom, Dad, good night." But I knew in that moment, she needed to be assured that this would not change our love for her, and it did not. I spent that first sleepless night trying to figure it all out, how to tell our family, our friends. She was going to be an adult in a couple of months and leave for college for a day after. My time with her was so finite, and I didn't have the answers. But what I did know was I did not want my daughter in that closet a moment longer. And backing up, that was one night. I can't even imagine the struggle of the past 2 years, what that was like for her. So the next day, I told her my plan. "Oh girl, we will tell the family at Thanksgiving when we'll be with Tiffany, and we love them, and it'll be great." And she gave me that teenager look. Do I have a teen here that wants to show me the teenager? Come on, Watson. The one where they roll their eyes. You say nothing. So Thanksgiving came and went, and she didn't come out. She chickened out, I thought. And the same thing happened at Christmas and her going away party. And then she left for college and we hadn't told anyone in the family. Well, what did I learn? I learned something really important. It wasn't about me. I learned it was not my place to out my daughter. And if she wasn't comfortable at Thanksgiving or Christmas or her going away party, then I needed to respect her process. I did so though while never completely understanding why she just wouldn't come out. But like my own mother, who didn't completely understand the whole St. Matthew thing, I knew I could count on my love for her, and the rest, that was gonna have to work itself out. I knew to trust in that love. I knew to trust in his love. Months later, Olivia, my daughter, explained to me that my approach made her feel as if I was pinning a big scarlet letter on her for all to see, world to judge. And she is so much more than that. She also explained to me that I never held a sit-down with the extended family to tell them my other two kids are straight. So in fairness, this shouldn't be any different. And that is my coming out journey as navigated by my daughter, supported by PFLAG, and empowered by love. And I have an epilogue for you. In February, that teen turned 22. Later this month, she'll graduate from that Midwestern college that recruited her 4.5 years ago with a BS in chemical engineering. And in that 4.5 years, I remembered the implicit callings of motherhood. I remembered to protect her. It's very easy to love her, and I will always wish good things for her, as I do all of our kids. And I'll close with something I'll tell anyone who'll listen. I love all my kids, even the straight ones. So thank you, St. Matthew Church, and happy Mother's Day to all the women in this room who have had the much appreciated occasion to protect, to love, and wish. Oh, I just looked at my daughter, and wish good things for our children.